5 second, like.
There we go.
We'll try to do our best.
Hey, whatever you say, I don't even know if it does sound.
Thank you. myself telling him, talk to my health. We have some pretty quick matches.
Yeah. thought that's where that was going to go.
There.
does have a 5 second delay on the camera.
Oh, okay.
Unless you let one rip.
You have this weekend?
Northwestern.
Oh, we're at Northwestern, right?
That'll be a good test.
Didn't they build a new stadium?
They did.
I don't know this coach, okay? You know him more than I do, okay? Okay, we're 5-0, okay? Within the last 2 weeks, he has dismissed 6 players.
Has he though?
Yes.
Good for him.
3 of them were starters.
Wow. Really?
See anything in? You never see anything about it? What talks about it?
Huh. Interesting.
You think they might have been bad apples there?
Were they kids that had been there? Were they from the...
I don't know. I just named who they were. I'm sure they were leftovers from last year because the kids he brought with him from James Madison knew him.
Yeah.
They weren't going to come.
No.
How many kids did he bring from JMU?
I think five.
Are they all starters?
That one running back he's got is that long. He had decent time.
Did you see they beat UNC a couple weeks ago? JMU did?
Yeah, I saw that. They're good.
See, Signetti's dad was the coach of West Virginia.
You told me that.
Okay, he followed Bowden, and then they fired him.
Signetti's dad.
Then Neil, huh?
Signetti's dad.
His dad's name was Frank.
Right.
And then he went and coached for years, I think, at Indiana University of Pennsylvania, IUP. So, Signetti, Kurt Signetti, was a quarterback at West Virginia. You know, dad's coach. There was a guy in front of him by the name of Hostetler. So he never saw the field. Years Northwestern have.
I'm not sure what their record is. I don't know that it's been as good as it has been. I don't think. You still got to go up there and play them. You know what I mean? They're good at home.
I remember when I was there, we went up to play that Northwestern.
Well, they used to be
years
a
ago. They just kept backfilling into Lake Michigan.
Yeah.
And that's what their campus is built on.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, this new stadium, one of the ends is the freaking lake. I mean, it's right there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's right on.
It's right on it.
The campus is right
on
the lake.
They have seats out there, but there's right behind it's the freaking lake. Northwestern is 2-2. And we have been cursed with a 23rd seed.
Oh, yeah, that's a kiss right there.
That'll do it. Give us a ranking, we're done. Give us a ranking. We didn't need that. Signetti ever smiles. I got never cracked a smile. Ever. As long as you win, who gives a crap, right?
I don't.
I heard he called out the fans a couple times.
He what?
Did he call out the fans?
Yeah. Yes.
What kind of crowd did they have Saturday?
Oh, and it was a good crowd.
Did you know he got rid of Hep's Rock, too?
He got rid of that. They moved it.
Hep Rock.
Remember, Hep had it. The one coach they had died of brain cancer, remember? And they had a rock. They all,
oh,
it was his rock.
Terry Hepner.
Yes, when he was coaching there. And when the kids came in, they slapped that rock. Well, Hep died. They kept the rock. With the ship, you know, not because of Hep, not because of that. But he got rid of the rock, man. Took it out, stayed.
Took it out,
stayed. And I'm not sure where it went. I asked Evan, because Evan was up there. He said they took Hep's Rock out. I said, what do you mean? He said it's not there anymore. On the north end of the gym when they come out. I said, okay. I think he's changed a few more things around too, which it's okay. He's trying to get people. First quarter to actually come in.
Funny mind that I
worked with at IU. He was just an athletic trainer. He texted me yesterday because he's a big Pirates fan. But he went on to PT school, but now he works at Penn State. But he works in the student health. He doesn't have anything to do with athletics. He got out of athletics. But I texted him back and said, Dean, when's the last time IU football was 5-0? And he was at IU working football for quite a few years. He said never. He said Mallory had him at 4-0. And he said maybe not until 1967. Were they 5-0?
That's what it was.
Yeah.
Who was coaching in the 67?
John Pine.
Alright, you good? Okay, I'm gonna head on out. And Sarah's got soccer tomorrow, so I'll be safe. Yeah, we need to move the game up a little bit. Yeah. No, we need to move the games up a little bit. Especially North Harrison. Probably 1967 until they played UCLA this season.
Was that in Pasadena?
It was.
Really?
It was in the Rose Bowl.
Yeah.
That's their home field.
I didn't know that. I didn't. I don't pay a whole lot of attention to college athletic coach, but I did see that Purdue fired your offensive coordinator.
They did.
He was at West Virginia before he...
Was that right?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Well, he wasn't getting it done.
No, I guess not.
Have you ever been to UCLA? Have you been there?
No.
I went to Poly Pavilion. It'll fool you. It's right on the street. I mean, the venue is right on the street. It looks like it's all that glass and stuff, but it's old. You know, it's an old, you haven't had it built, right? And it doesn't look like what you would think it would look like at all from the outside. You couldn't go in because they had it locked up or something. But I thought, really? You think this big stadium, it's not. It's like something. Really, it's a neat thing.
That's like, you ever been to Fenway Park?
No, I have not.
Fenway Park's right on the street.
Right.
I mean, it's just no parking
in the neighborhood.
Yeah, that's right.
It's like, it's really pretty cool. But back in the day when they built that in 1960, people were walking to the freaking game. It was a big deal.
Yeah.
Somebody told me it might have been Lynn Burdick. Remember Chris Wood?
He said, Roberta said he was enamored with UCLA. He went out there and worked as an equipment manager.
For real?
Yeah. I don't know if that's true or not.
Could have been. I don't know. Well, it's a nice campus. It's a neat campus.
I've never been on a campus.
What's the UCLA story? We were out there for FCA conference. We went there at 2 days. And we went to see the here in the corner, I think. Sure enough, there they were. All
really?
10 of them in a trophy case in the library on the fourth floor.
I'll be darned.
That would be a surprise. Especially coming from Indiana. You know what?
I'll be darned. That's interesting.
Some little diner downtown.
Yeah, I've heard stories about that.
That's said, my California people are going to know where that is, you know. Well, I talked to Terry Rademacher, who is an avid Cardinals baseball fan. He said, are the Cardinals in the playoffs? He goes, ah, no, they're out.
You're a baseball fan. Cardinals will win. That's on Tuesday.
Yes. Yeah.
So I got really
Early 2000s. They won it in 2006, 2011.
That was awesome.
I've been a Cardinal fan since I was about 6 years old.
What made you see it?
Well, I had a cousin, Tony Jacoby, went to North Harrison, went to Morgan Township in North Harrison. We played Little League against each other. We spent a week in our house in the summer. Me and my brother spent a week in their house. We lived right outside of Palmyra. Well, I was, originally we were Giants fans. I think just because of Willie Mays and Willie McCovey, and there's another one. Anyway, Tony's dad, my Uncle Melvin, who's 95, still living. Was a huge Cardinals fan.
Thank you.
brother John. That's his husband. He's a big winner. I started working baseball at WVU. You know, it was the first year. I wasn't able to go. They always were bringing a speaker for a baseball game. And Rose came in. And the guy said the next day, and he spoke on a Saturday night.
There's a big beer.
That's all I have.
That's exactly. Microbrewery. Everywhere.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm not a microbrewery.
You walk through, you walk through, you walk through.
Yep.
What was it? I don't know if I should go back.
That thing 10 years before. Was it built more damage?
I don't know
like,
if it was.
I feel like most of the stuff was in the river. You know, like, that was a little bit.
Wherever the river was.
Yeah.
The creek or whatever. Coast was hurting them like that, but it was all interior.
Well, they got, I don't know if you noticed, before the hurricane really, when the tropical storm got up there, there was just a swath of rain all up and down the East Coast, and it just must have hung there.
My nephew lives in Auburn, Opelika.
Right.
Okay. And I called Kay, my assistant. The night it was coming, I said, are you ready? She said, well, I'm gonna go stay at Allen. Because he has a generator. I said, that's a good move. I said, she's by herself. I said, there you go, so get over there now. And she did, and she said, I called the next day when we were getting our shit. And she said, no, we're sunshine in here. It was fine. You know, here. I said, she said, we got rain. Got a lot of rain. They said 6 to 8 inches of rain they were supposed to have. I don't know what they actually got.
Oh, last week I had close to 3 inches.
Did you really?
Yeah.
We got
a quarter inch Monday, 3/4 on Tuesday, and then
unloaded
Thursday,
on
Friday, Saturday.
That's true. I never thought about that. And then all that up, probably about 6 or 7 inches. We had 5 from the hurricane. We had 5 from the hurricane.
Yeah.
The wind was what?
Well, there were a lot of branches. There were
some gusts out here
down on High Road.
I got a big tree down in my yard.
Did you have any tree damage, Benny?
No.
You got a bunch of trees.
Wait, just branches down more than anything.
I got a whole pocket on my house.
Yeah. Did you have lose a tree?
It was actually my neighbor's tree.
You know where the Kaiser Boys is?
Yeah.
I think everybody knows where the Kaiser Boys
is.
So you're from the
street, from the town down a little bit? Right across the street,
and
then that's
your people. You know, are they right across the road?
They are. No, there's Delvin's right across the road.
Okay.
Bob and Debbie Bell. Marty's gonna come over and cut it all down. Marty was like, I don't have a chainsaw. I was like, I'll have to bring it. Like, everything's always fine with Marty. I'm like, that's a lot of work, Marty. It's a, I mean, these are retired funeral directors. It's a 20 foot took me a little while.
Does he have a wood burning stove?
He does, and I do too.
Oh, okay.
So I can take some, but it won't be seasoned for a year.
Yeah, it'll be a year or so at least.
Some of that stuff.
Just
I got a t-shirt.
T-shirt, I think. I don't think I did
that. Yeah. But.
Hilton, have you been behaving yourself?
Yeah, very
okay.
Well.
You can walk out.
I have been very well.
Because I worry about you.
Well, they were a little wild at the wedding the other night.
Did she get wild?
Vince was a little wild at the wedding.
That was nasty when you left. Did you close it down?
I left before they did.
Uh-huh. Yeah, but we left on right after.
That's what I heard.
Did you?
The DJ was not real good.
Did you have fun at the wedding?
Why not? You're not a barn girl?
I have more room than that.
Okay, if it was bigger.
Probably still not.
Okay.
I just didn't really like the design of it.
Oh, okay.
Like, I think if you're going to go to the barn girl, you'd be a barn girl on both sides.
Oh, okay.
Like, I don't know. There were just a lot of technical things about it that I just didn't like.
Okay. Design your own barn. You got property out there. You design your own.
Hey, there is.
My son, he had his down here at Perry's grounds and was going to have it outside. It did exactly what he wanted to have. The same thing. It rained. It was nice. For days, it didn't rain.
Yeah,
bro. Yeah.
People call me. Just give me your key.
Yeah.
I pulled it out.
Wow. I know.
That's at Murray.
Yeah, my dad took her and he came back. It is bigger than all that. Like.
Really? Yeah. Really, Georgia? Really?
She loves it.
How did you do that?
Good for her.
Yeah.
Well, good for her. Both for her.
Yeah.
I bet she's been with a lot of
people. She needs to do that.
Now, what do you do?
You have a
What are your plans? I mean, I'll talk to you more as the year goes on, but what are your plans for the sports team?
Perfect.
One more.
Go ahead, hit me with that. Now, what do you say? What do you want to do?
Yeah.